Hello, Manchester, and welcome once again to Ward 13. My guests tonight are Alderman Bill Barry of Manchester Ward 10, who's running for sheriff of Hillsborough County, and Leo Bernier, who's the Democratic candidate for County Commissioner from District 1.
Yes, John, thank you.
And both of them picked up unexpected endorsements this week. Leo from the Union Leader, and Bill from the Hillsborough County Police Chiefs Association, which is unprecedented that the incumbent wasn't endorsed. And we're going to get to both Bill and Leo shortly. I would just like to say a few remarks about, if this is viewers on Sunday, you've probably watched the Joe Kelly Lavasa show and you saw me with Steve Valancourt. That's the first time I've ever met Steve Valancourt, who's probably got the worst reputation of anybody in this state. You know, here's a man that called Annie Custer, who's a wonderful person, a beautiful person. I've met her several times. He called her a drag queen. That his Montreal, the Montreal drag queens, it's just such an ugly statement he made. It went national. And when we were at the Jefferson Day dinner, Bill, somebody came up and talked about, got an award, and they talked about Steve saying, he's ugly in every way. I had never met this man before. He was hostile to me in the green room where people gather before the show. He was hostile in the studio. He actually had his back turned to me. And, you know, he went on and on with his polls and statistics. And as we all know, there are lies, damn lies and statistics, you know, and he uses these polls and statistics to make his foolish points. He claims to be bipartisan, but the Democrats he endorsed, they were all free staters. And he made an outlandish claim that the Republicans were going to win 270 seats in the House of Representatives. And he said that there was a prominent Democrat, that if we all knew who this prominent Democrat was, it would astound us. But he couldn't give the name. Well, let's just say Joe had to stop the show, and we had to leave the studio because it became rather heated. I just want to make two points. When the camera was off, I told him that the Free Staters who have taken over the Manchester Republican Party are destroying the Republican Party. I know people have left the party because Tammy Simmons, who's a friend of the Free Staters, we have to be very careful because she's the chair of the Manchester GOP. The vice chair is a lawyer who's been here all 4 years, an admitted Free Stater who likes to threaten legal action against you if you criticize or if you call somebody, you know, try to out the Free Staters. But when it was over, I told him, the Free Staters are destroying the Republican Party. And you know what he said to me? I'm going to quote you what he said. The Free Staters took the Republicans to a great victory in 2010. That's what Steve Valancourt said. So when Steve Valancourt is okay with the Free Staters taking over his party. And, you know, afterwards, Steve, I think, was a little scared, afraid of me, because he just kept sitting in his seat. And I said, is he leaving too? And, you know, sheepishly he walked up. And then we went to the control room, and we started talking about the Democrat. Here's the conversation we had. You know, I challenged Steve in the control room about who's this Democrat. This is Steve. He's the most prominent Democrat in the state. I said, Ray Buckley? No, he's a Democrat who tells the truth. That's what Steve told me. I laughed because, you know, I said, no politician tells the truth. He's not a politician. You should know that. That's what Steve Valancourt says. He's not a politician. You should know that. And I said, how can I know it when you didn't even tell me who he is? This is like cloud cuckoo land, fantasy land. We could talk a little more about that, but and for you folks watching on Sunday, after my show, you're going to watch Manstadam. And I called in Lou D'Alessandro was on, the great Lou D'Alessandro. And I mentioned an event I went to when Kelly Ayotte was at the famous diner in Nashua, and she endorsed Scott Brown. He made the most outlandish statement I ever have heard. He thanked Ray Wieczorek for being his mentor. Now, he met Ray Wieczorek probably 10 minutes before at the diner, and that's Scott Brown. John, can we see the first Scott Brown?
I'm very proud.
to stand here today and endorse Scott Brown. Working together, I can assure you we'll put New Hampshire first.
Well, Kelly, thank you very much. And to before I start, I want to make sure that I address really the most important person here. Not that you all are not important, but my wife, Gail, has been with me for 30 years, but not for her love and support, being the wonderful mother to our children and wife to me. And I wouldn't be here certainly talking to you. I wouldn't have that sense of balance, that sense of family that we've tried, just like every one of you, to not only instill on our family, but on our friends as well. So, honey, I love you. Norton's here. George is in the back. He's obviously opened up his restaurant. Please come and patronize it and order his food. This is one of the small businesses that are trying to stay in business as a result of all the regulations that are affecting folks. Ray, thank you so much for your companionship and leadership, not only for our state, but being a mentor to me as well.
Yeah, let's see, too, the short one.
Oops. Ray, thank you so much for your companionship and leadership, not only for our state, but being a mentor to me as well.
You believe that Scott Brown, we call Ray Wazorik, the Wiz, his mentor. When was Scott Brown ever in Manchester before this political campaign? It's just outrageous. And one more thing. Hey, John, can you run those pictures of Carol? I was out with Carol Shea Porter. Carol likes to tour social clubs. There's me, Kathy Staub, Carol, Mike Lopez, and you know who that is, don't you, Bill? There's Paul Martin, though. Mm-hmm. We like to go. We were at the American Legion, which I belong to, the Sweeney Post, and Carol is the most normal person I've ever met. And a political activist told me, well, that's why people don't know what to make of her, because she's a normal, regular person. There we go. We love Carol. And we went to the social clubs, on the West Side. She just loves to deal with people. She's been in Manchester so many times, but she does this grassroots campaigning that I think is I have felt the tide. I've knocked on every door twice in Ward 10. The tide's turned. I think Carol's going to beat Ginta. It'll be a squeaker, but she's already up 3 to 5 points in the polls. And I know Gene's going to win by 54%. That's what I clock it at. But Steve and I went to loggerheads about ads. There's only so much ads can do for somebody like Scott Brown. It comes down to the Democrats are going to the polls. I hear it's an unprecedented number of absentee ballots have coming in for a off-year election.
That's correct.
But I'd like to get to our two guests now. Bill, we're going to start with Bill. Bill, you were endorsed by the Hillsborough County Chiefs of Police, which was unprecedented. They usually always go with the incumbent. And I wrote a story on Examiner, on my column about that, saying that one of the reasons that you probably got this endorsement, which was startling, was because not only did the chiefs of police of Hillsborough County have faith in you, but they didn't have faith in Chief Hardy. And Bill, I know you like to run a clean campaign, but since I ran that article, I've heard some things. Do you mind if I share them?
Go ahead.
Okay. This is rather incredible to me. I wish I'd had this a week or two ago. I think this is quite scandalous. I found out that these are my notes that I transcribed. In the summer of 2013, Patty LaFrance, who is the
county attorney,
and who's a Democrat, by the way, initiated the plan to create a countywide drug task force, and it was presented to all the towns. It didn't include Manchester and Nashua because we already have our anti-drug groups, our anti-drug task force. And she reached out to Sheriff Hardy. So the county police chiefs of the towns meet, and the first two meetings were very well attended, according to my sources, and Hardy didn't show up. When the third meeting was scheduled, and I guess the local sheriffs are wondering where the sheriff is, Patty LaFrance asked him to come. And he sent a sergeant. Now, I was in the military, and I think, Bill, what is the ranks? There's a sheriff. There's a deputy sheriff, right?
Yeah, the sheriff, the chief deputy captains, lieutenants, and then sergeants, and then the regular deputies.
So a sergeant, I think, would be the equivalent in the Army of a company commander or something, not a very high-level person compared to... He could at least send the deputy chief. But he didn't show up. And later on, in May of 2014, LaFrance went before the county commissioners to present her budget. She discussed the anti-drug task force and her plans with the commissioners. She met with them in the morning, and she told them she needed to be funded certain line items at $1, $1. That would allow her to apply for grants from the federal government to finance this drug task force. So the county commissioners told her that they had to meet with Sheriff Hardy in the afternoon, and would she please come back? Well, Patty LaFrance went back in the afternoon, according to my sources, and the sheriff had spoken out against this task force. So guess what? The county commissioners voted not to fund the $1 line items. They voted not to fund it, so she couldn't get the grants for the task force. Now we go to August 2014. I think we're starting to have the spice epidemic and everything. Guess what? Hardy sends his sergeant to contacting the police, the police chiefs of the towns in Hillsborough County. Guess what Hardy's plan is now? Is to have a drug task force headed by who? Sheriff Hardy. Now, Bill, I find this incredible. I'd like to point out Patty LaFrance is a Democrat. And Leo, I think all the commissioners are Republicans, right?
That is correct.
As is Judge Hardy.
Now,
Sheriff Hardy. I'm thinking of Judge Hardy in the Andy Hardy movies. This, I just want to say, I find this scandalous. I think it's the best argument for both you, Bill, to be elected, but also for you, Leo, that we need a Democrat on the board. And it's unprecedented. I don't think we have time to read the endorsement, but you were endorsed by the union leader.
That's correct. I was very fortunate. Again, you know, I've worked with the union leader for the last 30 years. As you know, I was welfare commissioner
since
1982 to 87, and I was city clerk. So part of the function that the city clerk does is a lot of it is what you have to do is that you copy a lot of minutes, and there was a good relationship that we had with the union leader in regards to minutes.
They respect your management ability.
That is correct, yeah.
That's apparent from the endorsement.
And we've worked well together in the past, and that's what the function of the city clerk's office is, to work well with the media as well as the public, and that was that's what we were doing for the last 22 years, and it worked out well, and it continues that way.
And it's not about one, I would call, egotistical sheriff trying to, what it seems like is he's poaching Patty LaFrance's idea, stymieing her out of his own ambition, and then putting it forward. Bill, we will get back to you, but I just would like to bring up, I think one of the big issues is what is going on at the Hillsborough County Jail, which is it's in Valley Street, right, Bill?
Actually on Willow, but it's on the corner of the actual address is on Willow Street, but it's on the corner of Valley.
And that's what we call the Valley Street Jail. Is
correct.
What is going on there? The liability, and even the union leader mentioned it.
Right.
The liability from there's been some alleged mistreatment of prisoners has opened up Hillsborough County to a great deal of liability, lawsuits, great financial losses. And the Republican commissioners, including Tony Pappas, just don't seem to...
Right. I think it's a serious matter. When you start dealing with the court system and lawsuits, I think there's just a little bit more things that should be addressed at this time, whether it be the staff that needs, we need additional staff, or we need training for these staff, pay well. I understand that a lot of people who work there in House of Correction leave after a few years, after they get educated and so on. And I think we need to address that issue. You know, things have changed. You know, what was happening 10 years ago and what's happening today has changed so much, and we need to change with the time.
We need more professionalism.
That's correct.
Because I remember Ed Sapienza, who ran against you, of course, works. That's his field of endeavor. And when I found out what they were paid, I was rather astounded.
That's correct.
It's a rather low pay scale for a very important job.
and a job that is very dangerous. And yes. I think you need to address that issue also. So you want to make sure they're educated. I'm talking about the House of Correction staff.
Yes.
For their protection as well as for the employee, as for the jailers.
Okay, we're going to talk to Bill a bit. Then we're going to get back to you because I fully believe I'm going to be elected to state rep from Ward 10, and I know I'm part of what is it the county
commission? County delegation.
County delegation. And we'll talk about how to put the responsibilities of that and overseeing the county. But Bill, tell us. Why you're running for sheriff. We've already talked about it, but you are a good man. I can tell many stories to these people. I'm always astounded when I'm with you to find out things that you have done. And I think what I'm finding out after publishing this article, there's a very good reason for you to be the next sheriff of Hillsborough County. Would you like to comment on that?
Well, I've been in law enforcement 30 years. 26 of them was with the Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office, and I worked my way up through the ranks. So I've done each and every job in the sheriff's office. I know the department. I know the personnel. I know that you have to deal with the county commissioners and the county delegation. I have a good rapport with the police departments throughout Hillsborough County. I've worked with quite a few of the now police chiefs while I was working in a fugitive unit. We reached out, and at one time or other, I've worked with their department, each and every police department in Hillsborough County, including Manchester and Nashville. I've worked on fugitive task forces and so on, not only the county agencies, but also state and federal agencies that I've worked with. Getting the endorsement of the police chiefs, I was somewhat surprised, but when you start thinking of the way, I approached, some of the police chiefs actually did call me, reach out to me, because they knew I was running, and they told me that they weren't happy with Sheriff Hardy because unfortunately, he wasn't committed to helping them out. And one thing that we all have to understand is we all pay county taxes.
Right.
Throughout Hillsborough County. And you would think that when you're paying county taxes, especially when you're dealing with these small towns that are way out there, that especially at night when they have one police officer on duty at a time, when they make an arrest, they have to transport that prisoner from their town all the way to Valley Street Jail in Manchester. And when they're doing that, it's leaving the town empty. They don't have a patrol unit anymore, and that's where the sheriff's office comes in. And the sheriff in the past has told them, and this is coming right from the police chiefs, is that the sheriff's office isn't mandated to do that. Well, they're not, but it's cooperation. And that's the big thing when you are the sheriff, you're the highest law enforcement agent in the county, cooperation goes a long way. And especially, again, when these people in these small towns, including Manchester and Nashua, are paying taxes. Now, do we have a problem with Manchester and Nashua as far as transporting prisoners to and from Nashua or Manchester? No, because, number one, they've got a big department. They can do it. They can handle it. But when you're dealing with the small towns and they have one person on duty, there's no reason in the world why we can't cooperate and work with them. The other police departments and law enforcement agencies that I've got endorsed by, Manchester Police Patrolmen and Supervisors, National Police Patrolmen and Supervisors, the Hudson Police Association, the Hillsborough County Sheriff's Association, the employees at the Sheriff's Office that also endorsed me. And it tells you something. I know part of the reason, and it's it's not an ego thing, but part of the reason that they did endorse me is because they know me and they know I'm a hard worker and they know me from past history working with them. But the other reason, unfortunately, is they just don't have can't endorse Hardy because they know that he just hasn't been doing the job. Something's happened,
Bill,
that he's just given up on it.
Bill, you're talking about character, and I know once again, we often are saying to you off camera, you've got to become more of a politician, and you don't want to be, which is you are very, the things you've given to the community are amazing. Every day when I'm, if we go out to something, I find out more about you. But and I know you probably wouldn't want me to raise something, but there's also an issue that people have brought up with me, and it's one of character, that Sheriff Hardy's paid $63,000 a year, but he's not a full-time manager, my sources tell me. I don't know, I haven't dug into this enough, but I understand that he's been working private security details when he should be on the job, that you would expect, since the courts are open Monday through Friday, that the sheriff is going to be working through Monday, Friday. And I've been told he's been working private security details at Market Basket and the Elliott Hospital. And we're going to go to you, Leo. When I'm on this, the county delegation, I hope that Sheriff Hardy's no longer the sheriff, but the county commissioners are letting him get away. If this is true, the county commissioners have let him get away with this. Yeah. Do you think that's proper? If he's working the private security details?
Well, let's not forget, he's an elected official.
Okay.
So that puts you in a whole different picture in regards to administration-wise. If there's any failure as a commissioner, if I get lucky get elected, then we would open it up and discuss it. But again, let's not forget, he's an elected official.
And is he taking advantage of that? Is that, because I'm hearing, what I see is a lack of professionalism. And is that because he's an elected official? I remember when you were on Amsterdam, people were always surprised that the sheriff is elected.
Right. Well, one other thing that I wanted to bring out, and it's near and dear to my heart, is dealing with children and the elderly.
Yep.
And 2 years ago when I was running for sheriff, I met with the same group of police chiefs. Some of them have changed. Some of them are new police chiefs. But I had told them my plan to implement a go to schools throughout Hillsborough County and educate the students, the teachers, parents, the bus drivers of the dangers that are out there dealing with our children. Back when I was working with the sheriff's office, I had approached Jim Hardy, and I had mentioned to him that we should be doing that. We should be leading the way in doing this, visiting the schools. And I have a very good relationship with the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. And I explained to him that we could get the resources from them to go. And he said, "Well, we don't want to step on other police departments' feet." And I said, "Well, we wouldn't be doing that. We'd be partnering with them and visiting the schools. We're not going to take over the county. We're not going to. And myself, if I'm elected, I'm not going to be going into Hudson or Merrimack or Francistown."
Right.
And taking over the towns, I'm going to be contacting the police chiefs, inviting them so that we do it together.
Right.
And that's what you need. I mean, you know, we don't want to – I'm very, very proactive. He's more reactive. If there's news today, he's going to react to that news today. I'm not. I don't want it to be the news today. I want to beat it before it becomes news.
Right.
I don't want these kids to be kidnapped and taken away from their families and having to deal with them as as victims. We need to stop it. We need to educate them, and even the elderly. There's so many scams that are out there. We should be going to the senior centers, to the senior high rises, and talking to the seniors and educating them about what's currently the scams of the day.
But the important thing you bring up once again, he's reactive. He stymies Patty LaFrance's effort, and then he takes it over for himself. I'd like to get to know Leo. We got 5 minutes left.
Sure.
Would you like to talk about the county budget? What does the commissioner do?
Okay, let me
the responsibilities.
So the viewers would understand that I used to be county commissioner in Merrimack County in 2008.
Okay.
So I'm very familiar with a lot of activities that go on in the county. My focus, the reason I'm running, is that I understand there's an $8+ million surplus.
Oh.
That should be returned back to the taxpayers, the county taxpayers, as well as some of those funds should be addressed the issues that we're having at the police at the House of Correction, as well as the nursing home. Because I also hear that the nursing home is their staff been cut over the years, and I think we need to address that issue. Those are the two main focus that the reason why I'm running for county commissioner, and I think we need to address those issues. And again, $8+ million surplus, I think half of it needs to be returned to the taxpayers.
And why are the, I'm going to call them the Republican commissioners, sitting on all that money?
Well, I think that I don't know. I mean, I can only talk back with my experience, and you always want to keep a contingency.
Right, but a rainy day fund.
We're
talking about over $8 million.
$8+ million. So I think they're just, I'm not really sure why they're holding it. But if I get elected, I assure you that a portion of it, or a large portion of it, will go back to the taxpayers.
Once again, we're talking about, there seems to be not just a management deficiency in the Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office, it seems that the county commissioners, there's a lack of proactive management. Are these people just reactive too? That they're just, like, as we're saying, you know, they're letting a sheriff get away with what many people might, many of the town police chiefs that endorsed Bill think is unethical behavior. Are they just being reactive too, rather than proactive?
Well, I think two of the commissioners are 20 years plus being commissioners. And I think change is good. And I think it's great when we have elections, because the question you asked me, you know, Mr. Hardy, does he have an extra job? Should he be in the office? You know, the voters will reelect him. And I believe they're going to elect Bill Barry for sheriff. That's our report card when we get when we're looking to get reelected. So the system works, and you'll see it happen again this year.
Now, just we'll wrap it up. We only got like a minute or so. The Fern and Ellis filed a $25 million federal lawsuit.
Right.
That seems to have been the event that's precipitated a lot of soul searching about the Hillsborough County commissioners.
Right. I assume, really? I hope, and I assume that the commissioners are on top of it. I have no indication, but that's a serious matter.
Serious matter because
$25 million is a lot of money, and you know how the court system works. You never know what's going to happen.
Right.
And I really think that I hope that the three commissioners have somebody who's professional that's going to represent them, or the county.
Yeah. Even filing the suit, that's going to kick up the county's insurance premium.
Right.
The coverage, when you have a badly managed system, whether it's the county jail or the nursing home, that costs us money. Not just from the lawsuits, but you see, when the liability opens up, suddenly we're paying higher insurance premiums.
Yes, maybe we should keep the surplus.
Maybe we're going to have to pay. Maybe one of the reasons they're keeping the surplus is to pay off, make a payoff in the future. But any last comment, Bill?
Yeah, real quickly, and I know you touched on 2010, the election, and that was when Bill O'Brien and it was devastating.
You wrote from last night's show,
right? But they it's true, because in one of the biggest cuts, and again, I'm nearing, you know, one of my passions is dealing with children. They cut the CHINS program, and CHINS program is Children in Need of Services. Yeah. The Sheriff Hardy should have been front and center. We had police chiefs, not only in Hillsborough County, all of them, but throughout the state, that stood up and were against cutting the CHINS program. Sheriff Hardy didn't say a word about it, and he should have been. He should have been front and center.
It's politics.
Again, he's the leader. Okay. He's the leader of the county. He's the highest law enforcement agent in the county. He should have been the one that was speaking.
Right. Well, we're at the end of our hour. I would just like to say that the politics that are being played by the Sheriff's Department, the county commissioners, it's just... And going back to the Bill O'Brien debacle, what he created in the state, the dysfunction for these budget cuts, irresponsible budget cuts. I'd just like to say, I think all three of us are for responsible spending.
Right.
But responsible spending entails responsibilities. And these cut and slash policies of Bill O'Brien and the Tea Partiers and the Free Staters, whatever they're rebranding themselves this year as the Liberty Alliance or whatever, are irresponsible. Now, I want you all to go out November 4th and vote. And I'd like to say, we Democrats, we're going to surprise people. I feel it when I'm out in the ward. We're going to surprise a lot of people, because everybody on the top of our ticket's going to win. And I hope you two gentlemen.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and I hope to see you once again next week in Ward 13.